Hi students, this is Shimi from Don Bosco Campus Vision. I am dealing with business statistics, wherein we are dealing with module number 4, index number. So in the last lecture, we had discussed about quantity index number. This was the second type of index number, weighted index methods. So today we are going to see the second method. In weighted methods, we had aggregate method as well as average method. So all the aggregate methods as well as the quantitative aggregated is done. Now we have to see the weighted average of relative method. So similar to your unweighted index numbers, there also we had seen average, aggregative and average method. Here also we have an average method. According to that only we have to follow here also. So this method is also known as the family budget method. So you could get problems asking the question to find the family budget or use family budget method and find the index number. So basically this means what you need to find the average of relative method. So this is weighted method. So this method is computed by the formula P01. We are dealing with price relative. So P01 is equal to summation of I into V divided by summation of V, or you can also say it as summation of I into W divided by summation of W. So what, dear students, V and W are either the value or weight of the commodities. Okay. So for the value or weight of commodities which is consumed in the base year, we can call it as P0 into Q0 will give you V0. So this is for base year. And for current year, it is P0 into Q1. So this is how you need to find. So the, and what is I? Where I is the index of the price or price relative. The same concept, the same denotations we also had in unweighted. There also we saw I, here also we have same I. This is how you need to, this is the formula to find price relative. So firstly, if you are not given I, you need to find the value of I by dividing P1 by P0 into 100. This is how we will find I. Then subsequently you will be multiplying that with the V or W, the weights. So let us see the merits now. The method has got following merits. The first merit is it is easy to calculate, simple to understand. Second is both the arithmetic mean and geometric mean can be applied. Third is it is flexible in the sense that old items may be easily replaced by the new ones. The fourth is it allows the construction of different index number with a common base in a combined manner. So we are taking the common base, we are combining it, right? So that's why are the merits of average of relative methods for weighted index. Now let us see the demerits. The demerits are, the method has got the demerits that there is no definiteness as to the manner of weighing and does not satisfy the time reversal as well as factor reversal test. So dear students, we are not taking any weights, and also both the time as well as factor reversal, which we call as the consistency test, are not satisfied here. So these are the demerits and merits. Now let us see an illustration or a problem related to average.
So let us solve a problem to understand this method. So the question is, an inquiry into budget of certain middle class families in a town gave the following information. The information ahead of expenditure, so price quantities are given for food, rent, clothing, fuel and sundry. So these part, food, rent, cloth, all these forms your commodities. Okay, price and quantity is given in this form. Now what to do? Compute a weighted arithmetic mean of price relative. So you need to find the price relative, which means you have to find the average method. For what? For weighted index, taking P0, Q1 as weights of the item. Also it is given, you have to identify P0 and Q1 so that the product of that will give you the weights of the item. Such an easy question, right? This is an illustration from your textbook. Okay, so go through the same. I have wrote down into my tabular form. Okay, here commodities,
food, rent, clothing, fuel and salaries. Price and quantities I have listed accordingly for 2002 and 2006. For finding the average method or for weighted average relative, you need to first understand how to find the price relative. You have to find I, then we are going to find the value, then basically we are going to product them up. Okay, so for finding I, we need to understand P1 divided by P0. So P1 is 90 divided by P0 is 100 into 100, that gives you 90. So second row, put 20 divided by 20 into 100. Similarly, 60 divided by 70 into 100, that will give you 85.71. 15 divided by 20 into 100, 75. And for the last column, that is 55 divided by 40 into 100, 137.50. So this, whatever we have got is I. This is your price relative. Now we need to find V. As in the question, already we have given P0, Q1 has to be your weights. So what is your P0 is 100. 100 into Q1 is 25. So 100 into 25, what we get is 2500. Similarly, P0, 20 into Q1, 20. 20 into 20, 400. 70 into 30, 2100. 15 into 20, 300. 400 here in the last row. Now what we have to find is our index. So the formula to find weighted of average of price relative, weighted average of price relative is product of I into V, the product of price relative into value. So I into V, that is 90 into 2500 will give you 225000. This will give you 40,000. This will give you 179,991. 300 into 75 will give you 2500. 400 into 137.5 will give you 55000. So we have to find summation of V as well as summation of IV. So for summation of V, we get 5700, and summation of IV we get 522491. So we got summation of B and summation of IV. Basically, to find the weighted mean of price relative, we are going to divide them up. That is summation of IV divided by summation of B, 91.66. So this is how you need to find the weighted mean of price relative. So for home assignment, question number 16 from your textbook is given as a home assignment. So this is exactly the same problem which we have already done. So solve this. Along with this problem, you have to do the same problem which is already solved. So two sums for home assignments. Thank you. Thank you.